Good morning students, today we will perform the Octoloni double diffusion practical. So coming to the introduction and the principle, so double diffusion in two dimension, it is a useful technique for comparing antigens for the number of identical or cross reacting determinants. So coming to the principle, in Octoloni double diffusion, both antigen and antibody, they are allowed to diffuse into the gel. So this assay is frequently used for comparing different antigen preparations. The method is called double, since the antigen and antibody are allowed to migrate or diffuse towards each other in the gel, and a line of precipitation is formed when the two reactants are met. This precipitation is highly specific and is used by people working with diagnosis and protein detection technique. So this slide shows the double immunodiffusion. So when you place the antigen and antibody in separate wells, the antigen and antibody, they move or diffuse into that of the gel, and when they come in optimal concentration, they form the precipitin line or band. So that is shown in the picture. You can see with the help of arrow mark it is shown, that is nothing but the formation of the precipitin line or precipitin band. So next we will move on to that of the materials required for the practicals. So now the materials which are provided in the kit are agarose, PBS, that is buffer, phosphate buffer saline, and one template, gel puncher, and slides, antiserum A, antigen A1 and antigen A2, similarly antiserum B, antigen B1 and B2, antiserum C and antigen C1 and C2. Along with that, we require micropipettes, microtips, distilled water, append of vials, etc. So next thing is, we will move on to that of the procedure, like how you need to prepare the gel and pour the agarose gel on the slide. So first thing is, you have to weigh 1% or 1.2% of agarose and dissolve in the respective volume of 1x phosphate buffer saline. Then boil until the agarose goes into that of a solution. That is, the you need to get a clear solution. Then after that, allow the solution to cool, like the temperature should be of 55 degrees Celsius. And meanwhile, wipe the glass slide with cotton to make it grease free. Then approximately take 4 ml onto each slide and pour on the slide. Allow to polymerize at least for 30 minutes. Place the well template. You can see that there is a template provided. It can be of any shape. Now whatever it is shown here, it is in the form of a flower shape or triangle shape or any thing you can take, or whatever the template which is provided in the kit, we need to take and place it below the slide and punch the wells in the gel with the help of a gel puncher. It is shown in the third diagram corresponding to the markings on the template. So with the help of gentle suction, to avoid the forming rugged wells, you need to slowly remove the agarose which you have made a punch on the gel. So the agarose plug should come out when you remove the gel puncher from the gel. So after making the gel, then next step is, you need to load the respective antiserum and the antigen into that of the respective wells. So load 10 microliter of antiserum A in the well, and bottom well antigen 1 and antigen A1 and antigen A2. So similarly, 10 microliter of antiserum B in the next well, and accordingly antigen B1 and antigen B2. So last one, 10 microliter of antiserum C, and accordingly antigen C1 and antigen C2. So once loaded, the slides should be incubated overnight at 37 degrees Celsius in an airtight container with a layer of moist cotton. That is, take a cotton, make it moist, place it on the petri plate. Then above that, you need to place the loaded slide and keep it in the dark for overnight. And the temperature maintained is 37 degrees Celsius. So after an overnight incubation, like we need to take out the gel and observe for the precipitin lines between the antigen and anti-serum wells by holding the glass plate to that of the light or against a dark background for the contrast in order to visualize the bands in a better way. So finally, now we will come to the results and interpretation. So now coming to the results and interpretation. So three patterns we can see here. The first one is the reaction of identity. So in this reaction of identity, we have taken the solution of antigen. It is placed in two adjacent wells and the homologous antibody is placed in the well, center well. And the two precipitin bands are formed and that will join at their closest ends and fuse. So therefore, that reaction we call it as a reaction of identity. You can see in the form of V shape. So next is the reaction of non-identity. So there what happens, you know, the unrelated antigens are placed in adjacent wells and the center well is filled with the antibodies for each antigen. The precipitin bands will form, but it is independent of each other and hence it will cross. So therefore, this reaction is known as reaction of non-identity and you can see in the form of approximately X shaped. Last one is the reaction of partial identity. So in this what happens, the antigen in one well and the antiserum in the center well comprise a homologous pair and the antigen in the adjacent well is a cross reacting antigen. The precipitin lines will form and it will fuse, but however one additional spur will be formed which projects towards the cross-linking antigen. So it is called as the reaction of partial identity. To look it is visualized as Y-shaped precipitin line. So this is how we can perform the octalone double diffusion in the laboratory. So thank you.